things I have trouble finding out before elections are judicial nominees. Of all the elections I've participated in, I've never been fully informed about the judges who are running and where they stand on issues. What resources do you recommend when it comes to researching judicial nominees?
Well, first of all, the local community councils in the past have allowed judicial candidates to speak. In some community councils, they no longer want judicial candidates. So if you are a member of community council. Mm-hmm. Community councils don't want us to speak. I found that in the 2011 election, a lot of places where I went in 2005 and 2000 and 1997, we were no longer invited. And I think that if you are part of a community council, you should demand to have the judicial candidates come and speak. Now, a lot of people think that you need to know how the judicial candidate feel about an issue in order to decide on what's the best candidate. But that's not the way to make that decision. Because you can be told anything. The issue becomes that you have to look at the broad context of that candidate. You need to get an idea of their background, their education, their thoughts about, how many of you look at Dr. Bull? I like Dr. Bull because when he's trying to determine whether a jury thinks, he never asks a direct question. Never ask a direct question. He gets to it in an indirect way, which says a lot about. But most of the judges feel like, I feel you should open up the doors and allow us to come in. And then we would be able to talk to you about where we stand on justice and law and order and all the other kinds of things.
Judge, I have a question for you. I've always wondered this. Isn't there an organization that actually rates judge candidates? And if so, what is it? And is it a trusted thing or?
Well, the Cincinnati Bar used to rate candidates, and I don't really want to speak about them, but every year or every election, it would be a different system, a different rating, a different this, a different that. It was never consistent. It was reeked with politics. It favored certain candidates. But you know, people are very interested about judges. What happens, and most of you who are in politics know that it's your name. So you can get all the bad publicity you want. When they get to the polls, it's your name.
They've
heard your name. So we used to say even bad news was going to get you elected at the polls. But I can tell you most judicial candidates want to speak in you need to take advantage of that and have that. Even in between elections, there's some things we cannot speak about. But most judges can teach you about domestic violence, can teach you about OBI law that has changed again, can teach you about children protection and that kind of thing, meaning that you can get an idea where what those issues that are very important to them. They can talk about gun law, the lack of education, the disenfranchised, the felons, the crime, and all of that. So open up the doors to them, and I think you can learn. And also the voters, legal voters, they always have
legal women voters.
They always have an article about judicial candidates, and we all appreciate that.
Great.